Hi, and welcome to this video. In this video, we're going to learn how to change the shape of a matrix or a vector. Let me begin by an example. So let's say that you want to create a matrix containing all the numbers from 1 to 100, and you want to lay it out in a 10 by 10 grid. So how do you do this? We know how to create the numbers from 1 to 100 in a 1D array. So this is just by creating vector equal np.arrange, and then we start at 1, and remember that the endpoint is not included, so we need to go up to 101. So let me also just return the vector. And now we have all the numbers from 1 to 100. But it's not a matrix, and it's certainly not in a 10 by 10 grid. So what I want to do is to reshape this vector into a 10 by 10 grid. So my matrix is going to be defined by vector. And the way I'm going to reshape this vector is by applying the reshape function. So the reshape function takes in the shape you want your matrix to be in. So this case, I want it to be a 10 by 10 matrix. So let me also return the matrix so we can see what happens. And what we get back is the numbers from 1 to 100, but each row has just 10 numbers here. So let's say that we want to go back to a vector again. So the way to do this is also by the reshape method, but this time we want to have the shape with just 100 consecutive numbers. So we write reshape and then 100 and see what happens. And now we get as output the same thing we started with. So let me print out the matrix again. So one thing to note is by using the reshape method, you're not creating a new matrix, you are just creating a view into your old vector here. So if I redefine an entry, for instance, the entry 0, 0, and I want it to be minus 20, like this, and I look at the original vector, then the first entry here is minus 20 as well. So this means that using this reshape method creates a view and not a copy. Okay, but we can reshape matrices as well. So let me say that my matrix here, I want to reshape it to be in the shape of, for instance, 50, 2, and run the cell. So now I have 50 rows downwards with 2 entries each. Okay, sometimes it gets a bit tiresome to do all the math. For instance, let's say that I know I want 50 rows, but I don't know necessarily what I need to multiply 50 with to get 100, or I don't want to type it into the calculator. What you can do is to write matrix.reshape, and then we specify what we know. We know the number of rows is going to be 50, and then instead of writing out 2, we write out minus 1, and let me compile it. So now you see that we get the same thing here. And the reason for this is that by writing minus 1, you're actually telling NumPy, just figure out what you need to put there to make up 100 entries. So one thing you might be wondering about is, what happens if I try to reshape it into something which do not have 100 entries? So let me try with .reshape. And let me write 23, comma, minus 1, try to run the cell. And then you see that NumPy is really not happy with you. It gives you back an error which tells you that you cannot reshape this array here with shape 100 into a shape with 23. And the reason is 100 and 23 is coprime, so it doesn't have any common factors. So what you're asking NumPy to do, it cannot do. So in last video, we talked a bit about what are we going to do to go from a 1D array into a 2D array with introducing the new axis and so on. It happens just as often that you are given a 2D array or even a higher dimensional array, and you want to go down to 1D array because the function you are trying to apply only accepts 1D arrays. So what we have learned is that what we can do is to use the reshape. So I can write matrix.reshape minus 1, and it will give me out a 1D array. But what we also can do is to use the flatten method. So let me write new vector and write matrix.flatten like this and run the code. And let me just write new vector. And you get the flattened version of the matrix matrix. But there is one difference between doing reshape method and doing the flatten. And that is that the flatten method gives me a copy. So if I try to reassign the first value of new vector, and let me say it's equal to 1000, then if we look at new vector, then it has 1000 inside the first entry. But if we write matrix, then it's still minus 20. So indeed, we see that using the flatten method gives us a copy instead of a view. So if you at any time want to force a copy, you can use the copy function. So for instance, if I want new matrix to be equal to np.copy of just my original matrix. Now new matrix is actually a copy. So to test this, we can write new matrix 0, 0 and just say that it's 0 again. So now the first entry of the new matrix is 0. But if I write out copy, then we see that for the original matrix, it's still minus 20. In the next video, we are going to learn several new ways to create new matrices. And additionally, we are going to learn to take the max, the mean, and so on a row-wise basis. So see you then. Hi, and welcome back. In this video, we are going to learn how to create some special kind of matrices and how to specify the axes in some functions like the mean and the max and so on. So there are some matrices that pop up so often that we have a special command in making them. So one of them is to create a matrix with only zero values. And to do this, we will use the np.zeros. And then you give in the tuple with your dimensions. So for instance, 3, 7. And if we run it, we will create a 3x7 matrix. We can also use the np.zeros on vectors. For instance, if we only give in the number 10, it will create a vector with 10 zero entries. A similar sort of command is the ones command, which creates a matrix with only ones. So it works exactly the same. So you write np.ones, and then you can give in a tuple with the numbers. So for instance, 10, 5, and run it. And here we have a 10x5 matrix. And also we can make vectors by just giving in a single number, like 12, run this. And here we have a vector with only ones. So if we want a vector with only two, you can simply take this vector here, multiply it by 2. And now you have a vector with only twos. Another matrix that we use often, especially in linear algebra, is the identity matrix. So the identity matrix is the matrix consisting of 1 along its diagonal and 0 anywhere else. So for instance, if I want the 3x3 matrix with 1s along its diagonal and 0 everywhere else, I can write np.i for the identity and then 3, run this cell. And then I have a 3x3 matrix with 1s along the diagonal and 0 everywhere else. So the identity matrix has always equal amounts of columns and rows. So the next thing I wanted to go through is how to use the sum function and the mean function when it comes to matrices. So first of all, I need a matrix. So here we have a matrix, and let me also just give it back to print it. So here we have a 3x4 matrix. So what I want to do with this matrix is to take the sum of the entries. So you can simply write matrix.sum and compile. And this will give you the sum of all the entries. So it works more or less exactly the same as it did for vectors. But let's say that you want to sum, but only over the rows. So you want to take 7 plus 8 plus 7 plus 3 give out the number. 4 plus 5 plus 2 plus 3 give out the number, and so on the last row. To do this, you can specify the axis inside the sum function. So you write matrix.sum, and inside here you write the argument axis, and you want to give in the number corresponding to the axis which vanish. So if I go up here, if I want the sum of all the rows, I want the columns to vanish, and the columns have the axis equal to 1. So if I now run this with axis equal to 1, I end up with 25, which is the sum of 7 plus 8 plus 7 plus 3, 14, which is 4 plus 5 plus 2 plus 3, and 11, which is 0 plus 4 plus 3 plus 4. If I want to sum over the columns instead, I can write matrix.sum, but this time I set axis equal to 0 because I want the rows to vanish. And if I run this cell, I get 11, which is 7 plus 4, 17, which is 8 plus 5 plus 4, and so on. So this works with several different functions. For instance, I can do the mean and write axis equal to 0. And now I get the mean over all the columns. So 7 plus 4 plus 0 divided by 3, which gives me out the mean, is 3.66667. And 8 plus 5 plus 4 divided by 3, which is the mean of this column, is 5.6667, and so on. So you can do this with the max. For instance, you can write matrix.max axis equal to 1, run this, and it gives me out the max over all the rows. So the first row have max 8, the second has max 5, and the last one has max 4. The last thing I wanted to say is that if you're not completely sure if you can specify the axis inside your function, you can ask for help. So for instance, if I write matrix.min and I want to see if I can put in an axis here, I can write shift tab, and this will give me out the duck string and open it here. And then you see that you have this axis which you can specify. Okay, this was everything I wanted to say, so see you again in the next video.